Problem 6.1, and it is once again based on auto cycle. The problem statement goes like this. An engine of 250 mm bore and 375 mm stroke. Works on auto cycle. The clearance volume is 0.00263 m³. The initial pressure and temperature are 1 bar and 50 degrees Celsius. If the maximum pressure is limited to 25 bar, find the following. The air standard efficiency of the cycle. Number 2, the mean effective pressure for the cycle. Assume the ideal conditions. So in this problem, one auto cycle is given for which bore and stroke lengths of the engine cylinder are given to you. Clearance volume is also given to you, and pressure and temperature conditions at the inlet are given. So you are supposed to calculate air standard efficiency of the cycle and mean effective pressure. Now to solve this problem, let us first draw the schematic. So let us consider a cylinder having its diameter 'd' and stroke length by L. So as you can see here, the clearance volume will be this, represented by this portion, and stroke volume will be represented by this portion of the cylinder. Now the given auto cycle can be represented on PV and TS diagram by as follows. In this PV chart, process 1 to 2 represents isentropic compression. The corresponding process is shown on TS diagram. 2 to 3 represents constant volume heat addition. The corresponding process is shown on TS diagram 2-3. 3 to 4 represents isentropic expansion. During this process, work output will be produced, and 4 to 1 represents constant volume heat rejection, and corresponding processes are shown on TS diagram. In this, P1 is the initial pressure, P2 is the pressure at the end of the compression, P3 is the process after heat addition. So P3 will be the maximum pressure in the auto cycle, which is given to us in this problem. And P4 is the pressure at the end of the expansion process. Similarly, T2 is the temperature after compression. T3 is the temperature after heat addition. So here, T3 will be the maximum temperature in the cycle. And T4 is the temperature after expansion. And here the system will return to its original state. Sorry, at state 1. So this way, auto cycle can be represented on PV TS plot, and the clearance volume and stroke volumes can be shown. Now after drawing the schematic, let us enlist what are the values given to us. So in this problem, bore means bore diameter 250 mm and stroke means stroke length. 375 mm are given to us. So D is 250 mm, that is 0.250 meter. L is 375 mm, 0.375 meter. Clearance volume is given as 0.00263 m³. This clearance volume is nothing but V2. Initial pressure is given as 1 bar P1, that is 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Initial temperature is given as 50 degrees Celsius. We will convert this temperature into absolute temperature, which will come out 323 Kelvin, and maximum pressure of the cycle will be P3. It is given as 25 bar or 25 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Now, after drawing the schematic and after enlisting all the values given to us in the problem, let us make assumptions. So, in the problem, it is mentioned all the processes are reversible because ideal conditions are there. This we are assuming. Okay. Now, what you are supposed to find out? First, find out the efficiency of auto cycle, and second, find out the mean effective pressure. Okay. Now let us do the calculations one by one. So let us do the first calculations to find out the efficiency of auto cycle. Now we know that efficiency of auto cycle is given by 1 minus 1 over r to power gamma minus 1. Let's say this is equation number 1. Where R is nothing but compression ratio. And it is given as V1 by V2. Where V1 is nothing but, if please refer this PV chart, where V1 is this volume. That is, starting from 0 to 1, V1 is the total volume of the cylinder. And it is given as the summation of clearance volume plus stroke volume. So V1 is nothing but VC plus VS. And on the cylinder body, I can represent this as V1. And V2 is nothing but, as you can see here, it is V2 is equal to VC, that is clearance volume. So from here I can say V1 is VC plus VS by VC. Where VC is clearance volume, and its value is given to us 0.00263 meter cube, and VS is called as stroke volume, and it is nothing but volume of the cylinder, engine cylinder, and it is given by pi by 4 d square L. So pi by 4, the value of D is 250 mm, and stroke length is 375 mm. So from here the value of stroke length comes out So volume of stroke length comes out 0.0184 meter cube. Therefore, from equation 2, compression ratio will be 0.00263 plus 0.0184 divided by 0.00263. Compression ratio is the value ratio of volume, so it will have no units. So after calculating, so it comes out 7.99. So I will take it approximately equal to 8. Okay. So this way I could get the value of compression ratio, and hence from equation 1, efficiency of auto cycle will be 1 minus 1 over 8 power 1.4 minus 1 into 100. So from here, efficiency of auto cycle will be 56.5%. Now here the value of gamma I am taking as 1.4 for air, because in air standard cycle air is used as a working fluid. So the value of gamma will be 1.4. So this way I can calculate efficiency of auto cycle in this problem. Let us move on to the point number 2. And it is asking to calculate mean effective pressure. Now if you remember the formula for mean effective pressure, it is nothing but net work done to the stroke volume. So PM will be W net to the stroke volume. Let's say this is equation number 3. So in this formula, we have the value of stroke volume Vs, but I don't have the value of W net. Now how do we calculate network output? It is nothing but heat supplied minus heat rejected. Heat is supplied during process 2 to 3 and heat is rejected during process 4 to 1. Both the processes are constant volume processes. So how can I calculate the value of QS? Q is nothing but equal to delta U. And this will be equal to CV delta T kilojoule per kg. Okay, so it will be CV T3 minus T2 heat supplied minus CV T4 minus T1 kilojoule per kg or W net CV into T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 kilojoule per kg. Let's say equation number 4. Now you can see here, for calculating the network output, we must know the value of T3, T2, T4 and T1. And these are nothing but temperature at end states T1, T2, T3, T4. T1, T2, T3, T4. Out of these four temperatures, we have been given the value of T1 only, 50 degrees Celsius or 323 Kelvin. So in order to calculate the value of mean effective pressure, we must calculate the value of T2, T3 and T4. So for that we have to go process by process. Okay, from process 1 to 2, recalling the various relations involved, considering the characteristics of this process, that is isentropic compression, then process 2 to 3, constant volume, 3 to 4, once again isentropic, and 4 to 1, constant volume. Okay, so let us go one by one. So my aim is to get the value of T2, T3, and T4. Okay, so let us first consider process 1 to 2 is an isentropic compression process. So when I talk about the isentropic process, these relations comes into my mind, relationship between pressure and volume, relationship between temperature and volume, and relationship between temperature and pressure. So using these three relations, I can get the value of T2. Okay. So let us first recall this. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 gamma. I am interested to calculate P2 first. So it will be P1 into V1 by V2 gamma. P1 value is 1 bar. V1 by V2 is nothing but compression ratio, isn't it? And this value is, we have calculated as 8. And for here the value of gamma is 1.4. So from here the value of P2 will come out 80.38 bar. See, my aim is to calculate the value of T2, T3 and T4. So I have to use the different relationship. Now, I have the value of T1, I have the value of V1, I have the value of V2, I can calculate the value of T2. So T1 V1 gamma minus 1 is equal to T2 V2 gamma minus 1. I am interested in T2, so it will be T1 into V1 over V2 gamma minus 1. T1 value is 323 Kelvin. It is given to us in the problem itself. As you can see here, T1 is 50 degrees Celsius. 323 Kelvin. V1 by V2 is nothing but compression ratio, that is 1.4 minus 1. So from here the value of T2 will be 742.07 Kelvin. So we have now the value of T1 and T2. Okay, so considering the process 1 to 2, I could get the value of P2 as well as T2. Now I also have the value of R, that is V1 by V2, 8. So from here the value of V1 can be V2 into R. The value of V2 is 0.00263 meter cube into 8. So from here the value of V1 I can also calculate. (0.02104 meter cube). Okay, now let us consider process 2 to 3. Process 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition process. So it is also a process undergone by ideal gas. So I can apply general gas equation to this process. What is the general gas equation? PV by T is equal to constant. So P2 V2 by T2 is equal to P3 V3 by T3. Here V2 is equal to V3 because process 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition. So they will get cancelled out. Now from here I can get the value of T3 as P2 into P3 by P2. The value of T2 is 742.07. The value of P3 is given as 25 bar, and value of P2 I have calculated as 18.38 bar. So from here the value of T3 is 1009.0 3-4 Kelvin. So now we have the value of T1, T2 and T3. Now let us get the value of process temperature T4. So for that let us consider process 3 to 4, and process 3 to 4 is a isentropic expansion process. So it is also an isentropic process. So what does it mean? I can apply this relationship . Okay, so I am interested in the value of temperature T4. So T4 will be equal to T3 into V3 over V4 gamma minus 1. In this equation, here you can see process 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition process. V3 is equal to V2. So as the process 4-1, so V1 is equal to V4. So putting this equality relationship of volume, I can write this expression as T4 is equal to T3 into V3 is equal to V2 and V4 is equal to V1. Gamma minus 1. Okay. Constant volume processes. Now, V2 by V1 is nothing but reciprocal of compression ratio. So, from here I can get the value of T4 as T3 is 1009.34. V2 by V1 is nothing but 1 by 8 and 1.4 minus 1. From here, the value of T4 I could get as 439.34 Kelvin. Now we have the value of T1, T2, T3, T4, and I am interested to calculate mean effective pressure. So this is the formula we have to calculate W net, Cv T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1. Okay, and formula for mean effective pressure is Pm is equal to W net over Vs. So from equation 3 and 4, mean effective pressure is given by W net over Vs. It will be Cv. Cv is common in both the case, T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 to the stroke volume Vs. Cv, the value of Cv for air can be taken as 0.0718 into 10 to power 3. T3 is 1009.34. T2 is 742.07. T4 is 439.34 minus 323. This is the net work output, and scope value we have calculated as 0.0184. So from here, the value of mean effective pressure, it is nothing but pressure, will be in Pascal or Newton per meter square. So this value comes out 5889551.08 Pascal, or I can take it as 58.8 × 10⁵ Pascal, or PAV is equal to 58.8 bar. So this is required answer. So this way you can solve this problem.